以色列人的预期寿命高于台湾，老人的照顾安养也时常受到媒体关注。一些退休人士选择搬到设施完善的老年村，享受便捷的服务和社区的温暖。这个村子位于耶路撒冷近郊，可以容纳300多户居民，也有养护病房照顾生活无法自理的长者。这里平时会安排义文和节庆活动，社区里就有犹太会堂、超市、餐厅和诊所。
We decided to move to this facility because it offers us security as we get older, and doesn't mean that we are dependent on our children to take care of our day-to-day needs. There are great benefits to living with people of similar ages. A lot of self-help is offered by the residents to those that need it, as well as the regular medical facilities which are on site. In summary,The self-help and the community spirit is very strong in this type of environment.
在以色列北部的海法市，则有一个为信徒预备的老人安养中心，称为以便以谢之家，是挪威宣教士于1976年设立的，如今有30多位住民。
I like it very much here because they all are believers and the love of God is here.And I have good contact with some people. And there's a lady especially I pray every morning with. The Lord's love is in this home.
这里的照护者除了雇员，也包括替代役青年和国际志工，都有共同的信仰。住民们可以一起查经，参加室内外的活动。
During the years, we see that there's more and more need for such a facility. First of all, people are getting older.We had new immigration. They need a facility and they have low income. So there's no question that there's a big need for a home like Ebenezer. There's greater need in the future for a nursing ward. It requires a license from the Ministry of Health.
除了以便以谢之家，在耶路撒冷近郊也有兴建信徒老人安养中心的初步计划。以色列教会正努力回应需求，让引法信徒得到妥善安置。